You guys hitch up the horse Nosferuses and you begin to make your way out of Dodge.
Guys, how are we gonna fit potato soup in the cart? He's too big.
He's a boar, Elvis. He can walk.
Oh, but Paul, his feet'll get tired.
All he does is walk, Elvis. He's a boar.
You guys are headed down the mountains. It's the middle of the night. It's dark. It's slow going. And this would be bad, but then you see the familiar Bingle light fly overhead. Down the mountain it goes, following the same road that you're on, and then it heads off towards the southwest.
Oh, hey, there he goes.
Are you sure it's Bingle?
Yes, Lowry, it's always Bingle.
Maybe he's just going back to the mountain.
The mine he was training at was to the east. This was clearly headed southwest, following the roads.
Oh, Bingle. Well, the spirits might be on your side, but apparently the gods are not. All right, come on, horse Nosferuses, yeah!
Luck is on your side. You follow the roads, occasionally stopping to ask people if they've seen mysterious lights pass overhead. Just as before, Bingle seems to be traveling often at night and is clearly visible when he does. You run into small townships and so on that all corroborate that, yes, some mysterious lights passed over here, like a while ago. You travel for days, going on into a week, and then your mom points out,
I think we might be getting close to the border of the Light Nation.
What, do you think he's headed home?
He could be. I mean, we have to follow, obviously. But just be aware, being a Dark Nation citizen is illegal in the Light Nation, so don't tell people that.
Right, yes, it stands to reason. Got it, guys?
Yeah, don't blow our cover.
Do not admit our proud heritage. Got it.
Okay, that established. You guys eventually come to a Light Nation checkpoint. It's not really big. It's mainly a custom thing. They come up and they say, hello, anything to declare?
Nothing in particular, thank you.
He points to potato soup. He goes, is this a boar?
Oh, that?
His name is Potato Soup.
Yes, that is a boar. His name is Potato Soup. I don't know why.
Well, technically boars aren't invasive species, so I guess he can come in. Did you know they're dangerous animals?
I know. He'll never hurt anybody. Well, actually, he hurt a lot of people, but he's full of squirbits right now, so he's fine.
Okay. All right, well, you be good. And then he lets you go past.
Weird.
What is?
Oh, just, it was a Light Nation checkpoint. I assumed they'd make us take our underwear off and wear it on our heads or something.
Your mom goes, don't believe everything you hear about the Light Nation. I mean, they are a very stupid and backwards country, but I'm sure we make up a lot of rumors.
Sure, but like what, like half of them gotta be true, right?
On you go, periodically stopping off at frontier villages to confirm that, yes, in fact, mysterious lights did appear overhead. Bingle is so easy to track, and you just keep on going further and further southwest. It's possible, if not likely, that he's headed for the Earth Nation at the south. But while you're thinking about that, you stumble into something peculiar. You approach a much larger town than usual, and immediately something feels a little off. In particular, the entire town smells kind of like lavender, rather than the usual raw sewage. As you get closer, you see that all the drapes and all the other upholstery, it's all floral pattern. And there's fake flowers put up on all the buildings. You get a little ways into the town, and you look around, and you realize everybody in here is a woman. You haven't seen a single man. A lot of them all stop and stare at you as you pass.
Hello, ladies?
Are you men?
Yeah. Right, guys?
Yeah.
Even Potato Soup is a guy.
Boo.
Why do you ask? I mean, I feel a little offended, you know, like I don't come into your town and be like, hey, are you ladies? Obviously, you're ladies.
Well, it's just, do you have visas?
Visa? To be men? To be men?
No, to come into our town as men.
I need a visa for that?
What, are you from the frontier villages? Another girl leans in. She whispers, they look like they're from the Water Nation. The girl you're talking to goes, oh, are you guys traders?
Yeah, we got a bunch of furs and stuff. You want any?
Oh, no, you guys can't stop here. You have to keep going. Law says no men in the women villages. You have to go to the men's village down south.
You're kidding.
No, you will actually be beheaded if you stay here in the women's village. You can pass through, but don't stop.
I don't believe you.
Fine. Stop. See what the town guards have to say about it.
Hey, have you seen any mysterious lights pass overhead?
Oh, yeah, on occasion. There's some light dragons in the forest to the south. They emit light sometimes.
Light dragons?
Yeah, they turn their bodies into light and they fly around overhead like big fireflies.
Have you ever seen one take the shape of a human?
Oh, no, those are just rumors. They won't eat your kids.
But I mean, like, would they look like a kid in the right light? I mean, explain light dragons to me.
I mean, I guess they could. Like, look, I don't know a lot about light dragons. I've got stuff to do, okay?
Well, who knows about light dragons? Have you seen? I'm looking for a mysterious light.
You'll have to ask the men, okay? Just keep going. Their village is just on the other side of the woods.
What the heck? Okay, all right. Come on, horse Nosferuses. Yeah.
You lead the horse Nosrises through the rest of the village, and it is just continually weird. Everything is floral print. Women are, like, leaning out of the windows and watching you. They're just like, oh my gosh, men, I think they're from the Water Nation. Do they have visas? Are they going to stop? Some of them try to attract your attention in various ways. Like, they let their hair fall down, and they flutter their eyelashes or whatever, but, you know, you have to keep moving.
Paul, I think I've read stories about this. If we stop here, they will eat us alive.
Like cannibals?
No, they're not really humans. They're monsters, and they look like humans, but in the night they turn into beasts.
Yeah, okay, I got it. It's weird. Hey, come on, pick up the pace a little bit.
You saunter out of the village at an accelerated pace, and afterward your mom goes,
oh my god, the rumors were true.
What rumors, Ma?
Well, the current king of the Light Nation is Tompkins the Mad, or so we call him. Here they call him Tompkins the Sane. I'd heard that in the inner provinces he'd issued a law stating that the men and women must live separately from one another. I thought for sure that was full of crap. I mean, can you imagine? A woman has to travel all the way from one village to the men's village, and then, you know, after they do their thing and they hang out for a while, and she's like, I think I'd like to have kids. You expect the woman to just, like, walk back to her village? Like, no, I would never do that. I would say, you know, I'm just gonna stay. Do you mind if I just lay around here for another week? And I keep doing that every week, and eventually, that's where I would live. I can't really imagine the men being that much less lazy either. I mean, they're probably even worse. You go to the woman's village to visit for a while, and what? Go home? No. It's insane. It defies everything about human nature. No one would ever naturally be like that. But by the gods, lo and behold, there it was. A village of only women.
It smelled really pretty.
I can't even imagine what that must be like. I hate women, personally, and I know that there's probably a bunch of women in that village who feel the same as me.
Well, that sounds okay, Mom. You and the others could put together a sisterhood of hate.
No, me and the women that hate other women are the reason why women need to be hated. You can't trust me. I hate you. The women who love other women are fine, but I will stab you in the back, along with all my sisterhood.
I suppose that does check out.
But if on the other side of that forest there's a village of only men, I dread to think of what that's like. Oh my god. If I know men, it's gonna be just full of men.
That is what a village full of men would imply, Mother.
See, exactly! That kind of attitude. But only that kind of attitude.
Well, you know, I dare say, Mother, that I get it from you.
Just shut up and drive, you idiot.
So there is a road through the woods. You don't see anything of particular note as you pass through. The trees are very tall, very strong, kind of like redwoods. When you come out on the other side, you see another town, but this one is dilapidated and, like, stuff is broken. There's chairs just sitting out on the lawns. There's a bunch of guys all armed to the teeth when you arrive, and they stop and they go, halt!
You're not gonna ask us if we're men, are you?
The guy in the lead is bald, but he's got a long mustache, and he goes, actually, I might. Are you guys men?
Yes, we're men, right, Lowry?
Yeah. I mean, I'm starting to doubt, but yeah.
Also me.
I don't know, you look kinda girly.
Well, the village of women told us that we couldn't stop there. Is this the village of men?
The guy spits on the ground. He goes, heck yes, it's the village of men. Nothing but men here. Nothing but manliness. And if anyone says otherwise, they're going to be hauled before the magistrate and executed.
Well, we're men.
Yeah, why don't you prove it?
I tamed this boar.
The guy sort of leans over. He looks at Potato Soup, who glowers at him. He leans back and he goes, yeah, I guess that's pretty manly.
Yes.
Okay, you guys can come in.
Actually, before we do, we're looking for mysterious lights in the sky. Have you seen any?
Oh, yeah, the light dragons. What are you guys, poachers?
Now, see, there that is again. What is a light dragon? Explain to me.
I don't know. I'm not a light dragon expert.
Well, is there somebody that is?
No. Though occasionally the kids go off in the woods and they find their eggs and smash them with a rock.
Okay. But they emit lights in the sky, which would, you know, confuse you if you were trying to look for a specific light. Is that correct?
Oh, no. I mean, they're really rare. You basically never see them. I mean, if you saw one, it would be a big event.
Oh, okay, okay. So have you seen any lights in the sky lately?
Recently? Well, I don't think so. He kind of looks around to some of the other guys in his gang, and they all sort of, you know, mutter, No, sorry, guy. We haven't seen any. Why, were you looking to buy one? So you go for the exotic pet stuff.
Yeah, maybe. I tell you what, I'll pay you. If you keep an eye out for him, I can give you something. Like, how would you like a nice fur?
The guy goes, I'll see what I can do. Anyway, you can come in. And the guys all kind of disperse and just, like, go back to whatever it was they were doing. Drinking beer, having an argument about a sports team, you know.
So guys, this village, it's nothing but men, just guys?
Yep, that's the law.
So what do you do? Do the women ever come visit you?
Oh, yeah, yeah. But it's a scheduled thing. We clean up the town before they come over.
I see. Well, guys, I don't know. If Bingle kind of gave us the slip by passing through this forest, I don't know if that was clever of him or just dumb luck, but, you know, trail's cold now.
The guy you were talking to goes, who, Bingle? Did you say Bingle?
Oh, sorry. Yeah, Bingle. He's my cousin.
Your cousin? You Bingle's cousin? You don't look like your Light Nation.
Hey,
whoa,
hey.
Wait. Do you...
Oh, yeah, sorry. That's what I've been telling people. This kid Bingle, he came up to the Water Nation, and he stole my watch. You know, I've been trying to get him, but people keep asking, oh, why are you looking for him? I don't mean to dislead. Do you know Bingle?
Yeah, I know Bingle. He grew up around here. He's Spoot's kid.
Spoot's kid? Does Spoot live here?
Oh, no. Spoot's dead. He was doing a handstand on a barrel, and then he slipped. Broke his neck. Poor Spoot.
Okay, but does Bingle still live in the house that Spoot used to live in?
Nah, after Spoot died, Bingle went out in the woods with some of the other boys. They got a thing going on out there. They consider themselves a liberation movement or something like that. You know, they come around and they try to fight us occasionally, but we're all bigger than them, so we kick their butts.
Out there in those woods? The woods we just came from? The woods where the Light Dragons live?
Yeah, they live in a bunch of tree houses.
Where, exactly?
The guy goes, okay, if you know there's like three turns on your way down here, right? So you're going to want to get to the third turn, and he starts to give you directions. He goes, yeah, when you get to the fallen tree, just go off the beaten path for a little while. You'll see a cattle trail. It's where the kids walk a lot. Down that way, that's where the tree houses are at. I hope you rough Bingle up pretty good. He shouldn't be stealing stuff.
We're gonna pound his butt so hard he'll never sit again, sir.
Cool. All right, you follow the directions. You get to the fallen tree and you start heading down the cattle trail. Then, overhead, you hear, a woo woo woo, followed by, caw caw.
What the heck is that?
You guys look up and, Elvis, a child drops out of a tree. He's wielding a knife. He goes,
eeeeee! Oh my god! Throw him off of me!
Okay, we're at the start of combat. Kids with knives and weapons and blunt instruments drop down from the trees all above you. Elvis, using your wind power, you huck that child as far into the woods as you can throw him. He gets like 15 meters. You don't really see where he lands. There he goes.
Whoops, sorry.
Yeah, he was like 6 years old. He was pretty lightweight. Also, don't be too sorry because one of them runs up and tries to stab Paul in the face with a spear, but Paul ducks underneath it.
Well, hey!
Another kid runs up and tries to tackle Lowry, but Lowry slaps him aside. A third kid goes in on Paul, jumps up on the cart, tries to stab you with the sword. You swat it away with your own sword. Kid number four is at the back and runs into Potato Soup. Potato Soup rears up on his hind legs, and the kid reconsiders. Kid number five, pretty much in the same boat, back there with Potato Soup, not really liking his position. Okay, Elvis reflexively killed a kid, probably, Lowry.
Create a pit in the ground under the kid that attacked me, then just close it up.
Okay, multiple attack, you create the pit, the kid does fall in, and then you just close the pit on him.
Teach you.
And Paul.
Okay, disarm the kid with the sword.
Yeah, you hook your sword in there, just swirl it around a little bit, and whoop, you pull it right out of his hand. It lands a few feet away, and he is now disarmed. Potato Soup runs up and bites a child. You can hear screaming back behind the cart. Now it's the kids' turns. A bunch of them jump up out of the bushes, like six or seven of them. They've got blow darts, and they all just, like, blow into them. Now, it's a crossfire situation, so you guys get hit with a couple of darts, but the kids also nail each other with darts here and there. One of them, the one that you disarmed, gets hit in the neck. He's like, ow! Sporkle, ow! What the heck? And Sporkle goes, well, get out of the way next time! The needles kind of went everywhere. You guys got hit. Potato Soup got hit. The cart got hit, the horse Nosrises got hit, most of the kids in the circle you're fighting with got hit, everybody got hit. Kids on the other side of the circle of darts got hit.
Oh my god, what is this?
There's a needle stuck in my arm. It's a big needle, what do?
Elvis, you're up.
Okay, leap out so I'm in a line with some of the kids on the edge with the darts and just do a big air wave, knock as many of them down as I can.
All right, you make your leap and already you're feeling just a little woozy. You're unstable, but whoosh, whoosh, whoosh. You throw a bunch of air waves so you batter some of those kids. Larry!
Okay, I'm angry. Target a single kid and then just flip the earth over on top of him. Smash him flat.
You slap your hands down in the soil and then lift them up like you're flipping a table. The ground then flips over on top of a child, smashing him. Paul!
Okay, just clutch at the spear of that other kid. But can we talk about this? Hold on.
All right, the other kid looks woozy too. The kids all on the edge of the forest are like reloading their dart guns now. We're going back to Elvis! You're starting to get tunnel vision. Everything's fading.
Just start throwing wind waves randomly.
All right, wind waves go out in every direction. You hit the cart. Your mom leans out the window and goes, hey, Lowry.
Okay, you point at another kid.
The kid goes, no, and he runs away.
Hey, come back here. I'm gonna kill you.
All right, Paul.
I'm just looking for a little boy to pound his bottom. We don't need to be doing any of this!
The other kid you're talking to kind of nods his head and then slumps over and falls to the ground. He is unconscious. Everybody else, the rest of you, the same happens. You don't have much more in you. You kind of just pass out. You come to, groggy and with a pounding headache, sometime later. You find yourselves all tied together around a very thick tree. There's about a dozen or so tree houses up here, and bridges leading between them. Some of the tree houses are better built than others. Potato Soup is tied to a different tree over across that bridge.
Potato Soup? How'd they capture you? It's okay. We had magic powers and we got hit anyway. It's fine.
It is not fine. Did any of you guys catch what exactly happened here? Because I passed out.
Your mom is also tied up with you. She kind of leans around. She goes,
I surrendered after you guys passed out. We got hit with a bunch of poison darts. I mean, not just us, like, a bunch of the other kids got hit, too. They're not exactly crack troops. I'd blame you, but the moment was pretty dang chaotic, and I mean, honestly, who would have expected it?
Well, thank you, Mother, for not holding us accountable for once.
Well, if this happens twice, I'm gonna be furious.
A tall boy, about 16 years old from the looks of it, walks around from inside of a treehouse. He goes, I'll tell you who's furious. Then coming up behind him is Sasha and Bingle.
Bingleberry! Oh, I should have known.
The tall kid goes, hey, hold on a second, how'd you know his nickname? He looks at Bingle. Bingle shakes his head and shrugs. Well, it doesn't matter. Bingle warned us about you. Dark Nation spies.
Spies kind of a strong word. We're more like kidnappers.
Spies kidnap people, Paul.
Oh. Well, in that case, yeah, we're spies.
Hey, gather round, everybody. Kids start coming out of their tree houses, and they all sort of assemble around where this kid is. The wood creaks somewhat ominously, but holds. Everyone? These Dark Nation spies came here to assassinate me, your beloved leader.
Kid, I don't even know who you are.
Bingle goes, yeah, these guys are trying to capture me. The tall kid goes, that may have been true to start with, Bingle, but as soon as they heard about the women's liberation movement, they knew we had to be stopped. That's why they came back here. Sasha crosses her arms and she goes, that lines up for these guys. They're all about ruining everyone's happiness.
Women's Liberation Front.
That's right. And you're too late to stop us, because our numbers swell every day. In fact, everyone, I'd like you all to officially recognize the first ever woman to join the Women's Liberation Movement. Let's have a big round of applause for Sasha. All the boys cheer, yay! And he goes, and not only is she a new member to our group, she's also my new girlfriend. There's an even bigger cheer from the boys, and then Bingle goes pale. He goes, what? Since when? And Sasha goes, oh, well, you know when I said I was going to go gather berries with Brongle here? We talked it over, and we decided to be boyfriend and girlfriend. Bingle goes, but you barely know the guy! Brongle, the tall boy, goes, it's all right, Bingle. She has a firm sense of justice. She's attracted to the righteous cause. Sasha kind of leans in, and he puts his arm around her shoulder. Bingle goes, but she wouldn't even be here if she hadn't been with me. Brongle goes, that's a good point, Bingle. In fact, everyone should learn from this. He turns to address the crowd. He goes, for years, we've been living under an oppressive regime that forces us to live separately from girls. But Sasha being here today proves that that was never meant to be the way things are. Sasha's just the start, and sure, she might be my girlfriend, but in the future, you guys are all going to have girlfriends too. You're going to get a girlfriend, and you, and everybody else. And all the boys, particularly the teenagers mostly, throw up a big cheer. Yay! Of course, they're all not likely to be as beautiful as my Sasha.
Oh my god, have you ever even seen a woman, kid?
He turns around, he goes, what, spy? You trying to imply my Sasha isn't beautiful?
Well, I didn't say that exactly. But, I mean, if these kids are interested in beautiful women, I know a thing or two about them. You know, where I'm from, they're allowed to mingle with the men freely.
They don't always like to, though.
Well, they can choose not to, but the point is, they mingle freely. And unlike Sasha, they wear makeup and have straight teeth and all kinds of nice things.
Sasha goes, hey! Brongle goes, you can't fool me. And for your information, we have seen women. Occasionally, they're allowed to visit the town of men or vice versa if they have a visa. Some of those women have very large boobs. I've seen them. In fact, we've got pictures. Trisket, go get us the pictures. Show them. A little kid, Trisket, salutes, runs off into a house, and then comes back with a crudely drawn picture of a woman. It's basically a stick figure with two giant basketballs drawn on the chest.
Oh, yes, I see. Very experienced with women.
It's about the size of her head.
The kid, Trisket, goes, yeah, they were a lot bigger than Sasha's. And Brongle turns around and shoots him the dirtiest look. The kid goes, Sorry, Brongle. Brongle just stares him down and then mutters, Trombude. No, not Trombude! Brongle throws up his hands. Trombude! There is a loud, vicious cheer, and the boys begin chanting, Trombude! 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 Other boys reach out and they grab Trisket. They hold his arms down. They sit on him so he can't move. He's screaming, No, not Trombude! Not Trombude, please! One boy grabs him by the face and tries to pry his mouth open. He squeezes his nose shut so he has to breathe through his mouth. Then, Brongle bends down in front of the kid and farts into his mouth. Trombude! The boys all cheer. Trombude! 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 Sasha has this look on her face like she just witnessed her grandmother drop a racial slur in the middle of a Thanksgiving dinner. They drop Trisket, and then Brongle turns to you guys, and he says, You three have a lot worse coming for you than Trombude.
What? What is worse than Trombude? What are you gonna do to us?
Brongle doesn't answer. He leaves, and then the boys all kind of disperse, just leaving you and Bingle and Sasha.
Sasha, hey, I don't know if you witnessed all that, but listen, don't let those boys get in your head, okay, about your beauty or anything. And I didn't mean to talk you down or whatever.
Yeah, there's someone out there who'll like whatever's going on with you, regardless of what you are.
Yeah, kind of.
Your teeth are crooked, or your skin is damaged from the sun, or your chest is small. Somebody will still like you.
Not me. I like some fat old knockers, personally.
Larry.
What, I'm not going to lie to the girl.
Okay, the point is, Sasha, what do you say we bury the hatchet and you know, we could come to a compromise.
You killed my mother.
Why do you always bring that up as though Bingle didn't share some responsibility for that? I mean, he is partly to blame.
Brongle is a wonderful man who has a couple of flaws, I'll admit, but he at least cares about the right thing, unlike you guys. You deserve whatever is worse than Trombude. I don't know what it is, but I hope you get Trombude and more. She storms off.
Sasha. Ah. Way to go, Lowry.
I'm not going to apologize for being honest.
Okay, Bingle. You grew up with these guys, right? What's worse than Trombude?
Bingle kind of shrugs and he goes, I don't know. I've never seen them do anything worse than Trombude.
Do you want them to do Trombude to us?
Kind of. It's funny.
Well, you're funny. You're just standing around. You're letting that Brongle kid steal your girl, aren't you?
He's not stealing her. He's just kind of borrowing her, maybe.
Oh, wow. Wow.
What?
Nothing. Just... That is truly pathetic, Bingle.
Well, we still have to travel. I mean, it's not like we're staying here forever.
Look, kid, we tried to hook you up at the fair. Do you remember? The fortune teller? That was Elvis.
Bingle kind of looks at you. He goes, Oh my gosh, I thought your boar looked familiar.
Yeah, that was me in potato soup.
Wait, then why'd you slap Sasha in the face? That didn't help me.
Oh, she made me angry.
The point is, we're on your side, Bingle. We were rooting for you. We were hoping to get you guys in the Tunnel of Love together. That was Lowry laying on the ground that got you in the Tunnel of Love.
I would have known if it was you guys. Besides, nothing happened in the Tunnel of Love.
Yeah, duh. Where were you on that one?
Look, Bingle. I know women, you know, fantastically well.
Your mom goes,
Shut up, mother. I know them well. I know how to attract women, believe me. If you help us get out of this... I will figure out a way to make things right with Sasha.
I don't know. She kind of hates you guys.
But she doesn't hate you.
Yeah, but if I let you guys go, she will hate me. I don't know. I'm sorry. And Bingle leaves. And really, before you guys get a chance to just tear yourselves loose or whatever, a couple of kids with weapons come along. They've got blow darts. They've got spears and everything else. There's like 10 of them on you. Your mom goes, Well, what now, geniuses?
You know, Mother, a little bit of constructive attitude would help us a lot.
I have already formulated a plan if everything else goes wrong. But I don't want to hold your hand and do everything for you. So rest assured, I will save us if I have to. I've already got a plan, and I'm convinced it's going to work. But let's see what you do.
Thanks, Mom. You know, it's great. That's great.
I don't want to be Trombude'd.
They said we're going to get worse than Trombude. He probably just poops on us, I mean.
That's assuming he just goes one step up.
I mean, like... What else is there? Is he gonna kill us? That's, like, what's better, being pooped on or being killed?
I will take the poop option. I want to live.
Yeah, look, it's dirty, but we come out of it alive.
I'd rather be killed. Don't poop on me.
I'm with Paul's mom. Just kill me.
Okay, so, do you guys come up with any ideas to get out of this?
You know, I'll be honest. Thinking about this from this kid's perspective, they have zero reason to trust us. We are apprehended. I can't think of anything I could give them, except for... in case they're really, really stupid.
Well, they're not that stupid. Like, they're about as stupid as, you know, teenagers.
Let's wait it out for a little while, I guess, and see if anything presents itself.
Okay, so you guys are held for the course of at least a day. In that day, there are routines. For example, they occasionally let you out to go pee off the side of the boardwalk or whatever. Your mom complains they let her climb all the way down the ladder to go pee in a bush. She's pretty persuasive and abrasive. You do get fed, but mostly what the kids are doing is they're putting, like, fruit on a stick, and then they're feeding you with the stick from far away. It's a little dumb, and you get a lot of stick in your mouth. It sometimes breaks, but they don't seem to care. Long term, these conditions probably would kill you, so you can't stay tied up like this indefinitely. However, they are being pretty careful about letting you guys out or putting themselves in danger. Also, every time they release you, they tell you that if one of you makes a run for it, they will just up and kill the others. Lowry, being up on this wooden platform, your earth powers are sort of neutralized. You don't really have access to your primary element. Elvis, you could make a run for it, but then they'll kill all your friends. Really, the only one who has any shot at getting out of this is probably Paul, who could create a field of darkness and then maybe fight his way out of that field. But it's hard to say how many kids exactly you'd have to fight. I mean, they are kids. They are easy to spook. If anything, you could probably break their morale pretty quick. So...
All right, guys. I got a plan.
One of the kids points a spear at your neck. No planning! No planning!
My plan is to not plan openly.
Well, before the end of this first 24-hour period, you're once again approached by Brongle. Sasha's with him along with some of the other boys, and he goes, "So I've been thinking. You spies... You're kidnappers, right?"
"Well, not by trade, definitionally, but it is something we're doing right now."
"Well, here's what I think. The women's liberation movement needs women. I mean, we can't keep calling ourselves a women liberations movement with just one woman. We should probably have at least two or three. So we'll let you go if you agree to capture more women for the movement."
"You want us to kidnap girls?"
"It's not kidnapping, it's liberation from an oppressive society."
Okay, but we're gonna catch some girls and then bring them back to these tree houses... with a bunch of, like, rowdy teenage boys and no adult supervision."
"There's adult supervision. I'm an adult."
"Okay, and what's the alternative if we say no?"
"You'll get worse than Tromboudet."
"I'd rather you just kill me."
"What is worse than Tromboudet? What is it that you're gonna do?"
"I've also been thinking about that. In honor of getting our first female member to the Women's Liberation Movement, I will smear your faces with Sasha's menstrual blood." Sasha goes, "What?" "Sasha, these men have terribly wronged you, have they not?" And she goes, "Yes, but when you said worse than Tromboudet, I thought you were gonna, like, I don't know, cut their dicks off or something." He goes, "Geez, no, can you imagine?" And she goes, "Yes, that is what I have been imagining." And he goes, "No, that's crazy. That's not even the theme of the women's liberation movement. Are you nuts? No, 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 geez. We're gonna smear them in your menstrual blood." And she goes, "Okay. Well, I've got bad news. I just kind of got done with that, like, less than a week ago. You've got, I don't know, another 3 weeks, give or take. I've been really athletic and stressed out lately, so it's a little irregular. I skipped a month." And he goes, "That's okay. We'll wait. I mean, they're not going anywhere." And she goes, I don't think I want this." And he takes her by the shoulders and he goes, "Listen, Sasha, either we smear them in your menstrual blood or we let them go. Those are the two choices." And she kind of pushes him away and she goes, "I don't think so. Actually, I might just leave." He grabs her by the wrist and he goes, "No, that's not one of the options. You can't leave. You're the first woman to join the Women's Liberation Movement. You have to stay." She tries to pry his hand off and he doesn't let her. He just, like, you know, tugs on her more. And she goes, "That is an option. I can just leave. I don't have to choose one of those two." And he goes, "You're not listening." And she goes, Okay, fine. All right, we'll do the menstrual blood thing. Just let me go, okay?" He lets her go, and he goes, "Sorry. Just, this is really important to me. I mean, this is all about justice." And then he kind of looks off, and the wind blows his hair. He's got a lot of hair, so. And she goes, Yeah. "Well, you know what helps with menstruation is a healthy diet, so I'm going to go pick some berries. Bingle, can you come with me?" Bingle runs up to her like a puppy dog. "Yeah. Help me pick some berries, please." He goes, "Okay." And they climb down the ladder. Brongle goes, "Wait, before you go, take some of the boys with you. Cheese Nuts, Durfle, don't let Sasha out of your sights." Sasha goes, "Thanks, I don't need protection." And he goes, "There's a lot of bad entities out there. I don't want you to get hurt. You know I care about you. You're my girl." She goes, "Okay, thanks." And then she climbs down the ladder and she goes off into the woods. Brongle turns to you and he goes, "So what's it gonna be, guys? Menstrual blood or kidnapping?"
"You know, we've done a lot of terrible things. I'm gonna say we're a very morally gray group. But helping you commit sex offenses, I mean, I don't know, it seems over a lot."
"They're not gonna be sex offenses. I'm saving women from an oppressive structural society thing."
Yeah, all right. "You know, I see that. Maybe I'm unfair and I'm judging you too quickly. All the women are clearly going to be much happier in your
orbit." "I don't think so. He seems like a jerk."
"Yeah, I mean, right. But it's not as bad as the society that forces men and women to live apart, you know? The society they're in now puts women like my mother in charge, and that's pretty much bad."
Brongle goes, "So you'll help?"
Yeah. But word to the wise, before I do help you, you know, your menstrual blood threat's going to fall apart when your girl escapes."
"It's not going to escape. Two of my best guys are with her."
"Yeah, but I don't know if you know this. Do you know that Bingle's kind of a savant? The reason why we're chasing him is because he learns new elements faster than anyone else alive. The kid is already a master of light, and he just recently mastered water. He's probably been learning earth from Sasha, and Sasha herself is an earthbender. She will probably crush your boys faster than they know what hit them. And then, Bingle has this thing that he does where he turns into light and he just gets away. It's happened to us and it's gonna happen to you."
Brongle looks nervous. He kinda like looks out into the woods.
"You know, Brongle, if women love anything, it's confronting them after they're mad. When a woman walks off angry, you should always immediately go after her and tell you why she's wrong and why you're right about everything. It helps them feel like you're able to cut through drama. Women love that. If you want to win her heart, I would take yourself and as many boys as you can gather up and make sure she sees things from your point of view."
"All right, give me a persuasion roll, Paul."
"There we go."
Okay. Brongle kind of mulls this over and he goes, Yeah. "Why does she need to leave with Bingle? She's been ignoring him the entire time she's here. Oh my God, she's gonna run. Boys, come on." He starts calling together all the boys. He's like, "Get your weapons, get your stuff, come on. Bingle's actually some kind of, what did you call it, a savant? Look, he's a whatever master. He does elements." He gathers up all the older kids, they grab their weapons, and they run off into the woods.
"Okay, once he's gone, turn to one of the younger kids still guarding us. Hey, kid, I gotta go to the restroom. You mind letting me out?"
The kid unties you. You know, you get up to do your thing.
"Thanks. Hey, by the way, I'm gonna escape, and if you try to stop me, I'm gonna chop your willy off. Do you want to stop me?"
The kid shakes his head no.
"Good, then untie my friends and the boar, and then get away from the boar very quickly, because I assume he hasn't been eating."
The kid unties everybody and then runs away. You are now free and the oldest and smartest person in this forest. Well, maybe.